Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to the Tom Dark Channel. I'm your host, Tom Dark. It's 3 a.m. and I'm schizophrenic. And today I'm going to be doing basically a little bit of a rant. If you saw the title of the video, then you already know what it's about. Weed, the stinky green schweed. The schweediest substance in the world, all right? I don't talk about drug use a lot in my videos. In fact, I don't know if I've ever talked about it in a video before. But today I just want to talk about why this particular substance kind of sucks. And more than like the plant itself, really, I just want to talk about like the people who smoke it. And it's their whole lifestyle and their personality. Those are the people I want to focus on today. And basically just criticize, meme, dunk on, destroy in this video, all right? By the end of this video, the stoner population is going to be in the ground, 6 feet under, no doubt. I'm currently in college, as many of you know. I'm a sophomore, and in college, a lot of kids like to relax or have fun by doing substances, and that's just kind of how it goes. I mean, it's probably been that way, like, forever, since the dinosaurs. It's part of college culture, and that's totally fine. I'm cool with it. I'm cool with, you know, partaking in it now and then. I am known to, from time to time, I guess. Just a little here and there on the side. But weed is something I don't really get involved with that much, you know, most of the time. And that's because of a number of life experiences I've had where I realized that to most people, like the vast majority of people, with some exceptions, weed is not a productive thing. It's just not. I remember in high school, like freshman year, probably when kids started smoking, maybe even like later eighth grade or something like that. But it was always like the skateboard kids or just the fucking degenerates who would come to class wearing a flannel that smelled like weed every day. And by the next summer, it basically was like their entire personality in school. Like that was their like group. Like you had like the nerds, the jocks, the, you know, the emo fags, the cringy people or whatever. And then you had like the, then you had the weed kids, and that was their whole thing. And these kids were always the ones that just didn't give a shit about any of their school or any of their real life, really. They just smoked, and that was the only thing they did. I'm not talking about like smart kids who had aspirations or even kids who didn't do well in high school as far as academics, but did have like other things going on and were excelling in other areas, you know, people with passions. I mean, people who every day the meme was go to school, you know, kind of basically like sleep through school and all that, and then go home and get high. And that was the rest of their day, every day. Like, they would just be high. The weekends, they would wake up, they would probably eat their fucking Lucky Charms, I don't know, go in the shower or something, and then get high, and like, watch TV all day. And that was their whole life, and there was something always kind of sad about that to me. I'm not one to cry about other people's like suffering or misery or throwing away their opportunities, but like, it is just a little sad to witness, right? And now that I'm in college, I realize that a lot of kids who just smoke weed, and just that's what they do, like that's who they are kind of degenerates in their own right. Like they don't really do much of anything. They don't really work. Very few of them have jobs. They don't really try their schoolwork even. They just get high and that's the only thing they do. For most of their waking hours, they aren't even lucid. They're like in kind of a half dream. And there's a whole culture right now around weed positivity and how it's the greatest thing in the fucking world. And you know, everyone wants it legalized. They want it to be a normal ingredient in their Lucky Charms. And if you want to smoke it, that's fine. Especially like, you know, maybe a few times a week or something, you'll probably be all right from that. But if you watch enough Joe Rogan, you probably think that like weed is the only thing you need other than raw eggs and raw beef to truly be the Sigma male, okay? Joe Rogan, for the amount of work he does, it's actually impressive how much he likes weed because, and I'll say this like outright, like Joe Rogan is an outlier. He has a high level of success and also is like always, always smoking. That is not normal. Most people who are consistently kind of in this half dream where they're in a daze, and just generally speaking, have no motive to go anywhere in life, they don't. Like something doesn't just fall on their lap and they end up like, you know, succeeding somehow. The way that people succeed, you know, actually like get somewhere in life, whether it be from YouTube or whatever, is from like working on things like that for the most part, like actually sitting down and doing the work. And most of the time you can't do that if you're high out of your mind. And also it just feels like sad, like people throwing away these opportunities and talents that they have. It's a very blackpilling thing to me. I get that, especially in the modern age, it's really easy to just like stop caring and think that's like the coolest shit ever. I definitely, you know, I get it from time to time. I'm like, fuck it, fuck everything, nothing matters. But definitely not doing anything with your life is just very sad. Inflation is at an all-time high. Our generation feels like it's fucked. It's going down the shitter. But like, don't give in to that hopelessness. You know, don't just become a fucking loser just because the world kind of wants you to right now, or it's easier to, right? Don't just become like a pot-smoking degenerate whose entire personality is being a stoner. Unless you're like making money from it, I guess, in which case it makes sense. I'm friends with this one kid who claims to make like $3,000 or $4,000 a month from selling stuff. So, I mean, good for him, you know, good for him. He's figured it out, I guess, but most people do not do that. I remember one time someone who I didn't know well, this girl, she like thought I was a stoner. She that was the impression she had of me. And I was like very offended at it. I was like, I don't want to be seen that way because I actually work quite a bit and get a lot of stuff done and I'm not a lazy person. I didn't tell her that because I wasn't going to be like, Oh yeah, I actually have a YouTube channel, but yeah, I definitely was like a little put off by that comment that she makes. I was like, no, I'm not. It's definitely one of those things where I think that everything should be really enjoyed in moderation. I personally have a very, very addictive personality, so moderating stuff like that is kind of hard. And I get that not everyone is like that, right? Some people have much, much better impulse control than me. Because, you know, when I like something, I really just like it, and I just do it until it fucking hurts, right? I do it until it fucking hurts to do any more, and then I do it more. But I think everyone would benefit from taking a break on the schweed a little bit. This is something I remember Sam Hyde used to talk about a bit, and I didn't really think was a real or a big deal. I thought he was kind of joking. I didn't think that he was super serious. I know he in his personal life is pretty anti-drug. Like, he's somewhat extreme. I don't think he does, like, anything, like, ever. Doesn't drink or any of that. I think in social situations, it's fine, and even for performance when, like, working, you know, there's probably, like, some stuff that I'd be willing to do to get more work done, Adderall. But weed is something that most people attribute as, like, this great thing, and really it's just kind of going to make you into a loser. There's people I know now who have a lot of potential and are super talented, way more talented and funny than I am, and they just don't get anything done because the time that they could be dedicating outside of their job to being on the Sigma grind set, you know, to like getting to a point where they don't have to work that shitty job they hate anymore, they instead dedicate to like getting high, sitting on their couch, scrolling through Uber Eats and like ordering Papa John's. Like, these are the people that order Papadias. You know what Papadias are? You know what that is? It's a folded fucking pizza. People pay money for someone to fold a pizza and send it to them through Uber Eats. Like, that has to be the saddest thing I've ever heard in my life. Cut that shit out right now. No more. Mangoes and weed are a great combo. You know, I actually think that chewing and glass are a great combo. I've been meaning to try them out lately. So stop being like this. Stop being lazy, please, for the love of fucking God. So I don't have to make another video about it on my YouTube channel. Slob on my knob and then get some stuff done. Anyway, that's it for this anti-drug PSA from Tom Dark. Probably don't take it super seriously. This is just kind of a dumbass rant, but yeah, this is how I've been feeling lately. Thanks for watching the video to the end. If you liked it, be sure to leave a like, leave a comment. If you disliked it, leave a dislike. Thank you guys so much for all the support in the recent videos. They've been doing better and better. You guys seem to really like them, and I appreciate that a lot. You guys have been fucking fisting that like button, fisting the you know, click on the video to watch it button, whatever that is. So thanks for that, and I'll see you all in the next one. Bye.